The mitral valve separates the lungs from your left ventricle. And when your left ventricle squeezes and it's supposed to send the blood forward across the aortic valve to your brain and the rest of the body, the mitral valve is supposed to stop that blood from going backwards in the lungs. And mitral regurgitation is when the mitral valve leaks and that blood goes back into the lungs. And the cardinal symptom of mitral regurgitation is really shortness of breath. And people get hospitalized with fluid in their lungs, they get swelling in their legs, they have a difficult time breathing, especially at night when they're sleeping.
Mitral regurgitation is clinically a very big deal and typically is involves people who are either too sick or too old to undergo the standard therapy, which is to repair it. And so that was really what the concept of the MitraClip was based on, is we needed a therapy which wasn't so traumatic to patients.
The MitraClip, or percutaneous mitral valve repair, is a much less invasive procedure. It's still done under general anesthesia, but it's no sternotomy, so there's no cutting the chest, no stopping the heart. If you come in through the leg and go up and you clip the leaflets together, the recovery is really much better. People go home the next day, as opposed to sort of the 5 to 7 day hospitalization for surgical mitral valve repair or replacement. And people are really functional right away, not the 8 week recovery from the sternotomy. If you're at high risk for surgery, you've had your advanced age, you're frail, you've had previous open heart surgery, those patients are really the best candidates.
I just simply put my hands, my life in their hands. I decided, well, there's nothing else I can do. And there really wasn't.
Mrs. Zecher, she's had previous open heart surgery. She was in and out of the hospital severely limited with shortness of breath and couldn't really live independently and do any of the things that she would want to do to have a good quality of life. Her options were to have a traditional surgery, which would be a redo surgery, which has a lot more risk and much more recovery, or to have the mitral clip.
I was just totally, I was in their hands. And I was happy with them, very happy.
She did really great, went home the next day, and has really felt great since then, with really minimal risk and a great recovery.
I don't know what they did with me, but they just kept me 2 hours there.
And now she hasn't been hospitalized, and she's not short of breath. She can live her life independently.
That's pretty amazing, to get me from nowhere to where I am.
There have been upwards of 18,000 patients who have clearly had their lives changed with this technology. And while as a practicing clinician, I thoroughly enjoy and get a lot of reward from the day-to-day interaction with patients, and I really revel in that. As the pioneer of the MitraClip, it's also extremely rewarding to see that we have been able to develop a technology here at El Camino that has a global impact in the healthcare. El Camino Hospital, as a community hospital, has a lot of advantages for doing creative, innovative research. We have a system that is very receptive to innovation and moves the process along in an expeditious way. That's not always the case in a large university or a large academic institution, so it really is a model that really facilitates the whole process of innovation and the process of improving medical therapy as quickly as possible.
It really builds for collaboration because we have doctors of varied training that work together and can percolate and get ideas from each other and really grow and develop the next new technologies.
I'm very grateful to be here. Those people gave me a new leaf on life, and that's just exactly where it is. Anybody who didn't put their trust in them would be very foolish. They saved my life, really.